Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, in these Gregorian Masses, we are going to pray from November 2nd to December 1st for these departed faithful souls in our families. For the souls of priests, nuns, and the departed souls in their families, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the souls of unborn babies and aborted babies, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the souls of Gomes Fernandez family, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the soul of Mendonca Fernandez family, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the souls of Rosario Menezes family, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the souls of D'Souza De Silva family, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the soul of Venetia Mendonca, offered by Tecla Mendonca and family. For the soul of Sebastian D'Souza, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members.
For the soul of Irene D'Souza, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members.
For the departed soul of Marina Fernandez,
offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Domitildes Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Kirobina D'Souza, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Maria Jamira Dias, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Benedict Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul Lily Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Cyprian Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the souls of Richard Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Florence D'Souza, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Tony D'Souza, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the souls of Sebastian Dias, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Richard Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Father Eusebio Jeffrino Fernandez, offered by Philip Nora D'Souza and family members. For the soul of Elizabeth Bastian, offered by Basil Bastian and family. For the soul of Stanley Bastian, offered by Basil Bastian and family. For the soul of Stanislas Peters, offered by Basil Bastian and family. For the soul of Jane Mary Bastian, offered by Basil Bastian and family. For the soul of Mrs. Aplan Pascal Almeida, offered by Mrs. Lalita Victor D'Souza. For the soul of Moses Susai Raj, offered by Monica Susai Raja and family. For the soul of Julema De Silva, offered by Vency and Cheryl De Silva. For the soul of Thomas De Silva, offered by Vency and Cheryl De Silva. For the soul of Egyptio Noranha Rodriguez, offered by Vency and Cheryl De Silva. For the soul of Irudaya Joseph, offered by Francis Joseph. For the soul of Ratna Mary, offered by Francis Joseph. For the soul of Neeti Pushpam, offered by Livingston Leon. For the soul of Grandmother Irudaya Mary Joseph, offered by Karen Anthony from Dubai. For the soul of Grandmother Teresa Joseph, offered by Calvin Anthony from Alwal, for the soul of Santosh Kumar Das, offered by Gayatri Das and Sheila Das, for the soul of Stanley DeCosta, offered by Christopher DeCosta, for the soul of Leonard Gracias, offered by Julia Gracias, for the soul of Lucica Gracias, offered by Julia Gracias, for the soul of Flavio Ferreira, offered by Julia Gracias, for the soul of Ejaldo Almeida, offered by Julia Gracias, for the soul of Jayashila Royan, offered by Nicholas Franklin Royan, for the soul of Irudinathan Xavier, offered by Remy Xavier and family, for the soul of Mr. Justin Mendes, offered by Mrs. Amala Mendes and family, for the souls of Anton and Lily Phillips, Terence and Dolly, Stuart, John, Molly and Alexander Rosie Rachel, offered by Daphne Phillips, for the soul of Anton and Lily Phillips, and for all the deceased members in the family, offered by Daphne Phillips, for the souls of Amala Rainsnathan and Arogya Swami Rainsnathan, Lourdes Swami Joseph John and Christina Mary Felix, offered by Sampurna Brito Dominic and family members, for the soul of Sri Julius Tigga, offered by Dr. Gloria Tigga, for the soul of Srimati Rita Topo, offered by Dr. Gloria Tigga, for the soul of Miss Sushma Tigga, offered by Dr. Gloria Tigga, for the soul of Mr. Deepak Tigga, offered by Dr. Gloria Tigga, for the soul of Lydia John, offered by Joan and Christopher DeCosta, for the soul of Catherine Sweedy, offered by Glenn and Pamela Caesar, for the soul of Moira Clive, offered by Glenn and Pamela Caesar, for the soul of Ari Jacob, Philomena Joseph, and for all the souls in purgatory, offered by Sarah Alfred and family, for the souls of Sylvester and Tracy Frank, offered by Loy Frank, for the souls of TK Joseph and Daisy Lewis, and for all the deceased members in the family, offered by Gerald Joseph and family, for the souls of Mr. D. Benjamin and Mrs. Antonimma Vasanta, and all the departed souls of family, offered by Mrs. Nana Pushpam and family members, for the souls of Muthukumar Anthony and Philomena, offered by Nixon and family members, for the soul of Elizabeth, offered by Nixon and family, for all the departed souls of Earl's family, offered by Rudy John Earl, for the soul of Thomas Thickedam, offered by Marilyn Joseph, for the soul of Joseph Variamattam Devashya, offered by Sebastian Joseph, for the soul of Dr. Suresh Kumar and all the benefactors, offered by Sister Arogya Mary and the community, for the souls of Juliet Pinto and Sylvester Pinto, offered by Edward and Rosette Pinto, for the souls of Celine and Lawrence Ruskinha, offered by Edward and Rosette Pinto, for the soul of Titus Pinto, offered by Edward and Rosette Pinto, for the soul of Clarence Pinto, offered by Edward and Rosette Pinto, for the soul of Donald D'Souza, offered by Edward and Rosette Pinto, for the soul of Noel Frank, offered by Loy Frank, for the soul of Eusebius Pinto, offered by Edward and Rosette Pinto, for all the departed souls in purgatory, offered by Vivian Joseph and family members, for the soul of Mrs. Bojja Mariamma, offered by Sister Bojja Vijaya and family, for the soul of Reverend Father Robert Leiting, offered by Sister Bojja Vijaya and family, for the soul of Mrs. Kathy Berger, offered by Sister Bojja Vijaya and family, for the soul of K. Maria Jersina, offered by Joseph Daniel and family, for the souls of Mr. and Mrs. Joseph and Celine Manjali, offered by Augustine Parakal, for the soul of Mr. Joseph Parakal, offered by Augustine Parakal, for the soul of Mrs. Rosie Manavalan, offered by Augustine Parakal, for the soul of Mr. and Mrs. Tricia and Ittup Parakal, offered by Augustine Parakal, for the soul of Mr. and Mrs. Augustine and Mariam Parakal, offered by Augustine Parakal, for the soul of Mrs. Mariam Pullokaram, offered by Augustine Parakal, for the soul of Kottayil family, offered by Bobby, for the souls of Penna Parambil family, offered by Bichu, for all the departed souls in the family, offered by Alphonse Richardson family and Xavier Anthony family, for the souls of Joseph Teresa Cheriman and other deceased members in the family, offered by Cheriman and family members, for the departed souls in the family, offered by Cedric Joseph Solomon and family, for the departed soul of Anthony and Michael Ammal, offered by Arul Anandam and family, for the departed souls of Y. Inaridi and Prakashamma, offered by Y. Lourdemary and family, for the departed soul of Kudumala Joachim Reddy and K. Maria Sundari, offered by K. Vinod Reddy, for the departed soul of Michael Ammal, offered by A. Arul Anandam, for the soul of Mrs. Edna Ann Enriquez, offered by family members, for the departed souls of T.V. Cherian, Trisimma Cherian, Anthony Joseph, K.A. Anthony, Jacob T.Y. and family members, offered by Suni Chubi, for the departed souls of Velan Marukudiyal family, offered by Kevin and family members, for the souls of Manarkattu family, offered by Kevin and family members, for the souls of the family tree of Stanley Morris and Cherise Dias Morris, and for all the holy souls in purgatory, offered by Stanley Morris, for the soul of Mr. and Mrs. Frank and Verna Marion, offered by Wendy Mengius and family, for the soul of Mr. Peter Joseph E., offered by Mary E. and family, for the soul of Mr. Loxley Arnold, offered by Wendy Menges and family, for the soul of Mr. Melvin Stewart, offered by Wendy Menges and family, for the soul of Lily Marion, offered by Freda Granger, for the soul of Daryl Menges, offered by Wendy Menges, for the soul of Frank Menges, offered by Wendy Menges, for the soul of Ronnie Marion, offered by Freda Granger, for the soul of Clifford Marion, offered by Freda Granger, for the soul of Leslie and Gloria Marion, offered by Freda Granger, for the soul of Brass Dias, offered by Freda Dias, for the soul of Serafina John Castellino and family, offered by Mrs. A. Pinto and family, for the soul of Bosset Dias, offered by Carese Morris, for the souls of V. Sirilaya, V. Therisamma, Arinana Alex Bhagyamma, Tandara Martin and Antonamma, Annie Teresa Ratnakumari and Sister Victoria, offered by Sam Vaddi and family members.
For all souls in purgatory, offered by unknown. For the soul of Mary Granger, offered by Freda Granger. For the soul of Joy Marion, offered by Freda Granger. For the soul of George and Elizabeth Marion, offered by Freda Granger. For the soul of Otto and Muriel D'Souza, offered by Berry Wu. For the souls of Shantaya Bandela and Koturi Chandraya, offered by Jyoti Bandela and Sumitra Bandela. For the souls in the families of Sundarambal Ramchandran and in the family of Veerammal and Ponnuswamy, offered by Arun Kumar and family. For all the departed souls of the Catholic Hub supporters family members, offered by F. Gomez and V. Gomez.
Just like a child who tries. Just is for the dear, and who delights to feel his presence near. Just like a child whose mind has not yet dawned, and whose heart is never prone. Here I come, O Lord, here I come just like a child. Here I come, O Lord, here I come just like a child.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends in Jesus Christ, in this Holy Eucharist, we are also praying for the departed soul of Manoj Kumar, offered by C. Manjali, brother-in-law of her, and she is one of the candidates here in the Holy Spirit congregation. So let us also pray for the soul of Manoj Kumar in this special Mass. In order to participate more worthily in this Holy Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins and confess them. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my fault, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
O God, who will that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your departed servants, that with the mortality of this life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, the Creator and Redeemer, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Remember from what you have fallen and repent. First reading from the book of the Apocalypse. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show to his servants what must soon take place. And he made it known by sending his angel to his servant John, who bore witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, even to all that he saw. Blessed is he who reads aloud the words of the prophecy, and blessed are those who hear and who keep what is written therein, for the time is near. John, to the seven churches that are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne. I heard the Lord saying to me, to the angel of the church in Ephesus, write the words of him who holds the seven stars in his right hand, who walks among the seven golden lampstands. I know your works, your toil, and your patient endurance, and how you cannot bear evil men, but how tested those who call themselves apostles but are not, and found them to be false. I know you are enduring patiently and bearing up for my name's sake, and you have not grown weary. But I have this against you, that you have abandoned the love you had at first. Remember then from what you have fallen, repent and do the works you did at first. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, your response shall be, those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
Happy indeed is the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor lingers in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of scorners, but whose delight is the law of the Lord, and who ponders his law day and night. A response.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
He is like a tree that is planted beside the flowing waters, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves shall never fade, and all that he does shall prosper. A response.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
Not so are the wicked, not so, for they, like winnowed chaff, shall be driven away by the wind. For the Lord guards the way of the just, but the way of the wicked leads to doom. A response.
Those who prove victorious, I will feed from the tree of life.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
Hear the word of God, keep it in your heart, bring forth fruit patiently. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 18, verses from 35 to 43. As Jesus went near to Jericho, there was a blind man sitting at the side of the road begging. When he heard the crowd going fast, he asked what it was all about, and they told him that Jesus the Nazarene was passing by. So he called out, "Jesus, son of David, have pity on me." The people in front scolded him and told him to keep quiet, but he shouted all the louder, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and ordered them to bring the man to him, and when he came up, asked him, "What do you want me to do for you?" "Sir," he replied, "let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Receive your sight. Your faith has saved you." And instantly his sight returned, and he followed him praising God. And all the people who saw it gave praise to God for what had happened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May these words of the Gospel wipe away our sins from us.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, somebody said, God gave us eyes so that we can see, and God gave us heart so that we can see better. God gave us eyes so that we can see, and God gave us heart so that we can see better. So we need to use our eyes and our hearts to see better in our lives, my dear friends. In the world according to who? So what is the who? WHO. World Health Organization. So according to the WHO, in the world, an estimated 253 million people are having the vision impairments, 253 million. In India, we don't use the millions. 253 means almost 25 crores of people in the world, they are having the vision impairments. And among them, 36 million people are completely blind. 36 million people means 3 crores, 60 lakhs people in the world are completely blind. And also, according to the another survey, 80% of our works depends on our eyes. 80% of our works depends on our eyes. That means the blind people, for the blind people, they cannot play outside games. Can they play volleyball? Can they play shuttle? They cannot play outside sports. They cannot watch serials. They cannot watch movies. They cannot go for swimming. They cannot go for picnic. So, for the blind people, most of the activities are restricted. That is why 80% of our works are done by our eyes. So, when we don't have the eyes, then we are so much of restricted, my dear friends. So, that is why in the Gospels we see, while Jesus was here on this earth, he gave more importance to heal the blind people. So let me ask you, how many miracles did Jesus perform while he was on the earth? The total number, which are recorded in the Bible. How many? You did not count, no? Every time we will be hearing, but we don't count it. According to me, maybe I am also wrong, according to me, 37 miracles were performed by Jesus. And among these 37 miracles, 6 miracles are related to the blind people. So he was healing 6 people who are with the blindness. And 3 people, he rose them to life. Only 3 people, those who are dead, he rose them to life. So now that is not the context, maybe some other time. So 6 people, so he gave sight to the blind. And today's story, we find in all the synoptic gospels. What do you mean by synoptic gospels? Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. No? Okay. So only we have 3 gospels which are known as synoptic gospels: Matthew, Mark, and Luke. So this story is recorded in all these 3 gospels. In the gospel of Matthew, you find it in the chapter 10, where you see 2 blind people were healed. Not one, but 2 blind people were healed. In the gospel of Saint Mark also, you find in the chapter 10, where you see 1 blind man was healed, and his name was mentioned. His name was Bartimaeus. Okay. Now in Luke's gospel also, 1 man was healed, but his name is not mentioned. But they say this story is same. When it is in the gospel of Matthew or Mark or Luke, this is the story of the man called Bartimaeus. He was healed of his blindness, my dear friends. Now in the gospel, let us see, we see a place called Jericho. So Jericho is the prominent place that we find mostly in the Bible. Also, it is one of the oldest city in the world. Jericho to Jerusalem, 15 miles distance. Jericho to Jerusalem. So we see the context. Jesus was going towards the Jerusalem, and this is going to be the last trip to Jerusalem in order to attend the Passover festival. So as he was on his journey to Jerusalem, now he reached Jericho, and from Jericho to Jerusalem, how much far? I have already told you, 15 miles. And Jericho was also the place of Zacchaeus, the short man, no? It was also the place of him. And about Jericho, you can read 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 19 onwards. Maybe that can be your homework. So that is about Jericho. So this happened in the place called, today's miracle happened in the place called Jericho. The second one is, what is the name of this blind man? What is the name of this blind man? I already told. The same thing is in the Gospel of Mark. There the name is given. What is that? Bartimaeus. So what does it mean by Bartimaeus? What is the meaning of the name of Bartimaeus? These days, we keep the children no names without any meaning. Okay, Bartimaeus means Bar, B-A-R. This is from Aramaic. Bar means son of. Then Timaeus, that means son of Timaeus is called as the Bartimaeus. Who is this fellow? He is the son of Timaeus. His father's name is Timaeus. Because he is the son of him, he is called as the Bartimaeus. That means practically, he was not having actually the name. So this fellow is called Bartimaeus. That is why in the Luke's gospel, we don't find his name at all. But in the gospel of Mark, we find his name Bartimaeus, which means son of Timaeus, my dear friends. Now from his life, we can learn some lessons. The first one is, Bartimaeus knew his situation very well. Bartimaeus knew his situation very well. He knew that he was a blind man. He knew that he was a beggar. Because he was a beggar, because he was a blind man, he doesn't have the family. He must have had the family, but the family left him. So where he was living? He was living on the outside road. So he was not having the house. He was not having the family. He was not having the friends. So he was a depressed man. He was a sad man. So he was a sick man. That means sickly, not only physically, also mentally, also psychologically, also socially, also spiritually. He was a sickly man because he was a lonely man. He was a poor man. He was a beggar. Then he was living a life of depressedness and he was not having anybody to take care of him. So this is the situation of Bartimaeus. Last time I told you, knowing about ourselves is the best knowledge, and forgetting about ourselves is the best knowledge. It is a divine knowledge. Knowing about ourselves is the best knowledge, and after knowing about ourselves, when we forget about ourselves, then it is called as the divine knowledge. So from his life, what we have to understand is, he knew his situation very well. So we need to ask ourselves, do I know my situation very well or not? When you know about yourself only, then when you know about your weaknesses, about your strengths, only then you will be able to act according to it. Because he knew his situation very well, he humbled himself. See, when you don't know about yourself, it is very difficult to be a humbled person. Always pride. I am somebody. So I can do this, I can do that. So when you don't know only, this is the problem. When you know about yourself, there is no problem. That is the first one. Second one is, he knew the Savior. He knew the Savior. When he heard the people passing by, usually he used to cry, alms for the blind, alms for the blind. So all those years, he must have been crying out. Whenever he heard some people were passing by, he used to shout, alms for the blind, alms for the blind. But today it is different. His cry was different. Today he is not asking for alms. Today he was asking, what happened? Who is passing by? Then they told, Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. Now he was not asking for alms. What he was asking? He was asking for mercy. Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Why he was shouting this one? Because he knew the Savior. He knew that Jesus can heal him. So he not only knew about his situation, but also he knew the Savior. Only this man can touch me. Only this man can heal me. If I am not going to use this opportunity, then I am going to miss this opportunity forever. Now or never. So I must get his attention. So he doesn't want to lose this opportunity. That is why he started to shout out, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. So my dear friends, the bad news is all of us are sinners. The good news is we are sinners with the Savior. The bad news is all of us are sinners, and the good news is we are sinners, but we have the savior who can save us, my dear friends. The third point from his life, what we can learn is, he did not allow anything to stop him. He did not allow anything to stop him. Somebody said, to get rid of your nonsense, sometimes you have to lose your common sense. To get rid of your nonsense, you have to sometimes lose your common sense. See, he was shouting more, and the people were saying, shut up, man. You old man, you blind fellow, shut up. Don't disturb the master. He's so busy and we are not able to listen to him. He's teaching something. Don't shout. Then what this fellow is saying? He's shouting even louder. That means he lost his common sense. Because to get rid of his nonsense, he felt his life is a nonsense. So to get rid of that, he lost his common sense and shouting even more louder, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. And here the important thing that we must notice is, who is blocking him? Who is blocking him? The people were blocking him, no? And those people are not the Roman citizens. Those people are not the Gentiles, unbelievers. But who were blocking him was those who are following Jesus only. Those who are with Jesus, those who were listening to his teaching, they were the ones blocking him. They were the ones who were shouting at him, stop, shut up your mouth. He is so busy. So, you better don't shout and so on. So also in our lives, my dear friends, most of the time, the irony of life is, we think that these people will help us. But those are the ones who pulls us down. This is the irony in the life. Actually, these followers, what they are supposed to do? When they had seen the blind fellow, they must say, come man, Jesus is here. We will take you to Jesus so that you will get healing. They are supposed to help him, but they became the block for his life. So also in our lives, maybe we need to ask ourselves, as we are the followers of Jesus Christ, are we helping the people to come near to Jesus, or are we becoming the stumbling block? Because of our actions or because of our words, have we become a block for the other people? Once a Guruji was there and he was having a servant. The servant loved the Guruji so much, so he was serving him all the time. After 1 year, another fellow came and joined. He said, Guruji, I love you, Guruji, and I want to serve you also. So he also became his follower. So now Guruji is having 2 followers. One day Guruji went some far place by walk and he came back. He was tired, so he was taking rest. And the first servant was pressing his legs. Okay. Now the second fellow came and said, Guruji, what is this? I am also your follower now. I also love you now. Please give me also chance to serve you. Why you are only giving for the first fellow? Then he said, there is no problem. So he told, for the first fellow, you press the right leg. For the second fellow, he told, press the left leg. So they were massaging nicely. They were pressing nicely. As they were pressing, something happened. The right leg touched the left leg. The right leg touched the left leg. Now the one who is pressing the left leg got angry. He said, how dare that your leg touch my leg? And second fellow took the broom and he started to beat the right leg. Now the right leg fellow, he took the stick and he started to beat the left leg. What happened here? Both of them wanted to serve the master, but what they did? In the name of serving, they were fighting and quarreling. Is it not the true of the church today? The Catholics are finding difficulties with the Protestants. Protestants will quarrel about us and we quarrel about them. It is not about the Catholics and the Protestants. Even among our religious congregations, that we, in the name of Jesus, for all of us, Jesus is the master. And we say, we love Jesus and we are serving Jesus. And we have the competition here. It is not the healthy competition. Sometimes we want to pull other people down. Even among the channels, even among the priests, those who are famous priests, what happens? One fellow will be running one center, another fellow will be running another center. And these center fellows will be talking about badly about the another center fellow. So this is the reality of the church. We are the followers of Jesus Christ. We love him and we wanted to serve him. But what is happening is, in the name of serving, we are simply becoming a block. Here, Jesus' followers, instead of helping that man, they became a block to the Bartimaeus. So, am I like that? We need to ask ourselves, my dear friends. And the fourth point is, do something dramatic for Jesus. Do something dramatic for Jesus. He not only shouted, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me," but when he shouted, what really happened was, Jesus was standing still. In the Bible we see, when the shepherd calls, the sheep listen. But here, who is the shepherd and who is the sheep? Bartimaeus is not the shepherd, isn't it? Bartimaeus is the sheep. Now, written, when sheep is calling, the shepherd is listening. When sheep called, he stood still and he listened to him. So also, my dear friends, God has given us a gift of speaking, a gift of prayer. So we need to call out to God. And when we call out to him, what happens is, the shepherd, the savior, stands there and he listens to your need. And he was shouting that, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood there, and what Jesus did, you know? Jesus did not go to him. What Jesus did? He told those people who were shouting, "No, stop, shut up, fellow." He told them, he ordered them to go and bring that fellow, to call that fellow. So this is the message that we have to learn. When you become a block, Jesus will come to you and say, "Don't become a block. You are the person supposed to go outside and bring the people near to me." So now this fellow was coming. How did he come? Do something dramatic for Jesus, I told, no? How did he come? He left some things. He left his old garment. He rose up and he ran to Jesus. So also, when Jesus is calling you and me, we are supposed to leave some things and get up and come to Jesus. What is that leaving the old garment? What is the leaving the old garment? Which means he is leaving his past life. He is leaving his old habits. He is leaving his begging profession. He is leaving his loneliness. When Jesus called him, it was the good news for him. So he left everything, whatever he was having. He got up, he came to Jesus. So when Jesus calls you and me also, we have to do something dramatic for Jesus. We have to leave everything and come. Especially for the sisters, for the fathers. This is what is religious life, isn't it? When Jesus called you, when Jesus called me, we have to leave everything. We have to leave our parents. We have to leave our village. We have to leave our friends. And also, we are not supposed to get married. No family, no wife, no children, nothing. We have to leave everything and come and follow Jesus. This is what Bartimaeus did. He left everything when he heard the call of Jesus. The fifth one is, he was a man of faith. Whenever Jesus performs a miracle, he says the famous words, according to your faith, be it unto you. That means, when you have more faith, more things will happen. When you have little faith, little things will happen. When you have no faith, nothing will happen. See, the problem is not with Jesus. The problem is with us. Whenever he performs a miracle, he says, according to your faith, be it unto you. If your faith is more, you will receive more things. If your faith is little, you will receive little things. If you have no faith, you will receive nothing at all. So now, Jesus is saying to him, go, your faith has made you well. So whenever we approach God, we have to approach with faith, my dear friends. Then coming to the sixth point, he knows how to pray. He knows how to pray. When Jesus asked him, what do you want, fellow? What did he say? Immediately he said, Lord, let me see again. When Jesus asked, what do you want from me? Immediately he said, I want to see again. Then immediately he was cured. Somebody says, if God appears to you right now, at this moment, and ask you, ask Kalpana sister, what do you want from me? Right now, he appears and asks you, what do you want from me? Lord, just give me some time, let me think, let me pray. And God says, you have only 15 seconds. And if you are not able to say within 15 seconds, when the time is over, he will say, I will come back again after 150 years. You understand? So, when Jesus called him and asked, what do you want from me? He was ready with the need. He did not say, okay, let me think what I want. Now God asked me, and so on. So also, we need to ask ourselves, if God appears to you here right now, do you know what you want to ask? Do you have a need, an immediate need, which will help you, which will become a blessing for you, which will become a blessing for the other people? What do you want? Do you know? So he knows how to pray, my dear friends. The seventh one is, he followed Jesus. Jesus told him, go, your faith has healed you. But after getting the healing, did he go? He did not go. After getting the healing, what he did? He started to follow Jesus. He was praising Jesus. And because of him, all those people also were praising Jesus. See, here Bartimaeus, what we have to learn is, he is not a person who is only looking for healing, but he is a person who is also looking for the healer. He wants both healing and the healer. Oftentimes what happens? We want only healing. We want only the blessings, but we don't want the healer, we don't want the savior. Once we are blessed, once we are cured, then we will not come back again. Whenever there is a need only, we come to the Lord. But Bartimaeus was not like that. He wants both. He wants the healing, also he wants also the healer, my dear friends. So seven lessons we have learned. If you want also the healing like Bartimaeus, we are also blind sometimes. It is not our physical blindness, but sometimes we are blind also spiritually. We are sick also physically, mentally, spiritually, psychologically. If you want to receive the healing, you need to have these seven qualities of Bartimaeus. Only then we will be healed. Conclusion is, Bartimaeus was once a blind man, but now he can see again. The loss of one thing is not the loss of everything. Yesterday I was talking about the God's blessings in three ways. Physical blessings. How many senses we have? Five senses we have. And this fellow is now not having one sense. Isn't it? What he was not having? Sight. But he was having other senses, no? See, he was not disappointed so much. See, the loss of one thing is not the loss of everything. See what he was saying? He can speak. So he was shouting. So he used the sense of his shouting or voice. He has no sight, but he has the voice. When we reflect about his life, he had no eyes, he had no name, he had no family, he had no friends, he had no house, he had no happiness in his life. But what he was having, he had his voice, he had his faith, he had his courage, he had his focus, he had his persistence in his life. By using his eyes, by using his voice, by using his reasoning, he was able to regain his sight. So we should not focus on what we do not have in our lives. We should focus on what we have in our lives. He had his voice. He used his voice, shouting and so on. And so that he is able to regain his sight, my dear friends. He got the information, isn't it? He was asking the people, no? What is happening here? They told, Jesus of Nazareth is passing by. So that is the information he got. So using that information, he was shouting, and using that information, he was transformed. So also the information is given. Now I spoke to you, about 7 points. This is the information. If you use this information for your transformation, very good. If this information is remaining like information only, that's the problem. Oftentimes we hear, we have so much of information now. We know the Bible, we know Jesus is the Savior, but what is the problem is, information is remaining like the information, and it is not helping us to go through transformation. He got the information, he used the information, through his information, he got the transformation, my dear friends. And he knew very well, today is the day of salvation, you may not have tomorrow. Can any one of us say that tomorrow I can live? Today only is the day of salvation. Now this present moment. Tomorrow we don't know whether I will come here to celebrate the Mass or not. I am not so sure also. That is why in some of the convents they keep, when they have the sacristy, I think. So before going to celebrate the Mass, they keep something there. Celebrate this Holy Eucharist as if it is your first Mass, and celebrate this Holy Eucharist as if it is your last Mass. Don't know tomorrow you will be able to celebrate the Mass, fellow. So celebrate it meaningfully, as if it is your first Mass, as if it is your last Mass. None of us are sure that maybe tomorrow we will attend the Mass also. This may be the last moment. This may be the last moment that we have to listen to the word of God. So today is the day of salvation. None of us knows that whether we will have a tomorrow or not. Bartimaeus did not just want healing, as I told you, he also wanted the healer. To stay victorious, stay with the Christ. If you found it in Christ, you can only sustain it in Christ. So always be connected to God. When you are disconnected, what happens? The charger is there and phone is there, so you don't connect them. There is no charging. So Jesus is there. If you are connected to him, then you will receive the blessings and healings. If you are disconnected from him, then you will lose your power and the blessings, my dear friends. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Standing at the table, you said, "Yours be the bread our hearts can forget. We are the signs of your life with us. We are yours. We are yours. Take our bread. We ask you to take our
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and your words may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and glory of all his holy church.
Almighty and merciful God, by means of these sacrificial offerings, wash away, we pray, in the blood of Christ, the sins of your departed servants, further purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness those you once cleansed in the waters of baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We joy, we sing, our faith proclaim. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again, Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Tumabala our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, for whom we are offering this Gregorian Mass. Remember your servant Manoj Kumar, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Love is his word, love is his way, feasting with all, fasting alone, living and dying, rising again. Love, only love is his way, richer than gold is the love of my Lord, better than splendor and wealth. Richer than gold is the love of my Lord, better than splendor and wealth. Love is his way, love is his mind, sharing his last Passover feast. Christ at his table holds to the 12. Love, only love is his mark. Richer than gold is the love of my Lord, better than splendor and wealth.
Richer than gold is the love of my Lord, better than splendor and wealth. Love is his mark, love is his sign, bread for our strength, wine for our joy. This is my body, this is my blood. Love, only love is his sign. Richer than gold is the love of my Lord, better than splendor and wealth. Richer than gold is the love of my Lord, better than splendor and wealth.
Soul of Christ,
sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, embrace me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from you. From the malignant in me, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me, and it may come to you, that your saints I may praise you for all eternity. Amen.
Litany of the faithful departed. Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Saint Michael,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the angels and archangels,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the orders of blessed spirits,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Saint Joseph,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Saint Gregory the Great,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy patriarchs and prophets,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy apostles and evangelists,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy martyrs,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy bishops and confessors,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy doctors,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy priests and Levites,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy monks and hermits,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the holy virgins and widows,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All the saints of God,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Be merciful.
Spare them, O Lord.
Be merciful.
Graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
grant unto them eternal rest.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
grant unto them eternal rest.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
grant unto them rest everlasting.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy from the gate of hell.
Deliver their souls, O Lord.
O Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my cry come unto thee.
Let us pray. O God, the Creator and Redeemer of all the faithful, grant unto the souls of your servants departed the remission of all their sins, that by pious supplications they may obtain the pardon which they have always desired. Grant this, O God, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Eternal rest give unto them, O Lord.
And let your perfection light shine upon them.
May they rest in peace.
Amen.
My dear friends in Jesus Christ, today let us repeat the words of Bartimaeus. Two words all throughout the day. What the first word? What is the first word? Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. The second one is, Jesus, help me to see again. So throughout the day, whenever you have the time, better you repeat these two words. Jesus, have mercy on me. Jesus, help me to see again. Also on behalf of Catholic Hub TV and also all the viewers, so hearty condolences, Sister Simanjali, so for the departed soul of your brother-in-law Manoj Kumar, and we pray for his soul. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord may stand as a shelter for all who will call on His name, sing the praise and the glory of God. Could the Lord ever leave you? Could the Lord forget His love? Though a mother forsake her child, He will not abandon you. Though the mother
mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand as a shelter for all who will call on His name, sing the praise and the glory of God.